And now, as I said, Doris Collins will be with us shortly, but now we meet one of the most successful singers of recent years, one of those performers for whom statistics were invented. Her first album sold 14 and a half million copies, her second already sold more than 11 million. A remarkable success story so far, and there's more to come for Whitney Houston. They seem, in a funny way, quite pleased to see you as well. Anyway, welcome, and I'm glad
that
you're on the show. Now, we were a little confused about the relationships, because earlier on I was working out how to introduce you, and we said, Aretha Franklin's her grandmother, Sissy Houston's her cousin. And I said, what's your relationship to all these very famous names? Aretha is a friend.
Yes, she is. She's a friend of the family.
And Sissy Houston's your mother.
Is my mother, and Dionne Warwick is my cousin.
Well, with that kind of background, you had to be a singer, hadn't you?
I guess so, you know, kind of. I wasn't forced to be a singer, but I wanted to sing, but with those great influences, it was great to have that around.
When did you start singing in church? Because I know your mother is a minister of music.
Of music there, yes, in church. I started in church singing very young, and I guess about 13 or 14, I decided that I wanted to professionally sing. And my mom took me by the hand, and we went to the studio, and I learned my chops there. And then on the weekends, you know, I would sing in the nightclub with my mother. So basically, that's
so you were able to combine that. Rather, it was a strict Baptist upbringing, wasn't it? I mean, your mother is a very devout Baptist.
Yes, she is.
Yeah.
It was quite strict.
How can you combine that with the razzle dazzle of show business?
Well, it's great because it sort of keeps your head on straight, you know, and you have a good perspective on things, you know. So it kind of helped me out a lot.
Yeah.
Worked for me.
Does your mother advise you when you're singing now?
Oh, absolutely. She's not a woman who forces you to do anything or tells you what to do. It's kind of like when she sees little things, she'll indicate, you know, that this is this. And I always ask her for advice anyway, so.
Does she drag you back into church every so often to sing?
Oh, that? Yeah. Yeah, she beats me back into church. Yeah, she does sometimes.
Your success story has been extraordinary in such a short time. Massive records. You've just won a Grammy.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, do you have a thing? How old are you now? Very young.
I'm 24.
24.
Old lady.
Oh, bless us, yes. Yeah. You peaked. Do you feel there's not much more for me to do?
I hope not. I hope I got some more to do.
Well, that's the problem, isn't it? You've achieved so much at 24.
Well, I think there's still more to go, I would like to think, yeah.
Well, it's good to see you here. I hope you're going
to sing
for us.
Oh, absolutely.
Will you do that?
Sure.
Ladies and gentlemen, Whitney Houston.
More. open arms of a love that's waiting there. And if somebody loves you, won't they always love you? I look in your eyes and I know.
Whitney Houston, where do broken hearts go? And now the question I most want to ask my next guest is, why do all clairvoyants and healers seem to be...